New York, Tokyo, and Seoul. A satellite cocktail celebrating music, art, sports. Reaching out. Touching the future. Hello, tomorrow. Bye-bye, Kipling.
To our friends in Korea, Annyeong Hashim Nika. And to our friends in Japan, Konbanwa or Konnichiwa. I am Dick Cavett. I'm in 3D here at 4D, which is, as you can probably see, is a nightclub. We are here live for an electronic demolition derby. And I think what is being demolished is one of the world's favorite cliches, and that is Rudyard Kipling's O East is East and West is West, and never the twain shall meet. We have to tell Rudyard to hold on a bit about that, because with a little technology, we think we can change all that. And that's the idea behind this program, to show East and West can meet, we hope. Now, in two shakes of a tiny satellite's tail, I have summoned Tokyo. They're going to get ready to join us shortly, live on the line. And I think, as you can see, it's daytime on the other side of the world. And if Tokyo isn't east or west enough for you, then let us go now to Seoul, Korea, where more than 5,000 athletes are gathered for the 10th Asian Games. At this very moment, the high point of those games, the grueling marathon is being run. And Catherine Switzer, the woman who broke the sex barrier in the Boston Marathon.
Dick, and here we are in Seoul, where we're watching one of the most exciting races in marathon history. What you're seeing now, Dick, is the Mapo Bridge, the famous Mapo Bridge. And as you can see, 26-year-old Takayuki Nakayama from Japan is on a world record pace.
Our entire fate tonight rests on a satellite up there somewhere in space. And we're going to do something that I think has never been done on television before. A mudong is a kind of shaman who is, well, it can invoke a blessing. She is now going to bless the satellite. This is the first time we've had our bird blessed on television.
Stand by.
Annyeonghaseyo. Hi, Skip Blumberg here in Seoul, Korea, with a report on culture. For instance, this is Cha-jun no Lee, an ancient sport played between villages, the object to jolt the riders off the giant rope loop. It's still played at cultural festivals. Another game, seesawing. Traditionally, women weren't allowed out of their backyard during the day. Jumping seesaw allowed them to see over the garden wall. But this report is not only about Korean tradition. Here in Seoul, in the Batangol Gallery, is the first annual avant-garde performance art festival. This piece, called Process, is a performance by contemporary artist Shin Yong-sung with political overtones. It's about tearing down the structure. This is the East Gate Market in Seoul, where you can get whatever you need, such as squiggly fish, health sandals.
How much are those?
2,000 won.
Ginseng root in a jar. Turtles. Here in the market, outside of shops and stalls, barkers aggressively attract customers to buy their wares in a style that approaches performance art. And another kind of workers' performance, the farmer's dance, traditionally performed by and for farmers in the field to entertain and to stimulate them to work faster. Well, that's it from Seoul. Now back to New York, or Japan, or a tape, well, wherever.
Back on the streets of Seoul, Nakayama from Japan is still on an exciting world record pace. It's one of the most exciting marathon races we've ever seen, Fred, because he is doing it all by himself.
But you know, the 10th Asian Games is a representation of one-third of the Earth. We have 3 billion people in Asia. It's been a fantastic show.
Thank you.
me just preface this by saying that if we get through this bit, it'll be a miracle and a tribute to people in both parts of the world that we're working from, or all three of them. So,
yes,
shall we try to clink? I heard it. Domo arigato. Very good. Kanpai.
What about another?
It's very interesting to meet culture and people between east and west, and west, south and north.
Well, I'm sure you're right, and I haven't a clue what you said, but it was beautifully delivered, and I could tell from your face that it was sincere. By the way, a friend of yours wants to say hello. He is the artist Keith Haring. Issei. Haring-san, Issei-san. He seems to like your shirt or something. It's an unforgettable thing to see if you ever get the chance to see them in the theater. From Tokyo, you are seeing the incredible Sankai Juko. They describe their work as an eternal voyage. It's a dance on the universe. Their clothes are by Issei Miyake, the costumes I think they'd be called in this case.
You know, it seems that sports isn't the only art form the Koreans excel in. They also have a very rich heritage in music and dance as well.
I doubt if I have to tell you what the gentleman's profession is that you can see on the screen right now. Sumo dates back 1,500 years. At least it's a kind of sports with sacred ritual overtones. The wrestlers are like to live almost a monk-like existence. Konishiki-san, or I should say Konishiki-zeki, can you hear me at all? Can we get Konishiki to the microphone? Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you good.
You look great. We only have time for you to tell us your current fighting weight, which is ikura.
I'm about 229 kilos.
And in pounds, that's even more. The sumo are strong as can be. It's not flab, folks. Now, I have no idea what I do at this point.
Welcome to the Elephant Roundup here in Surin. This is certainly among the most spectacular events in the world. There are 140 elephants here today. We happen to be the announcers here. I'm a missionary. I'm working among the Kuwait tribes, people who are the owners and trainers of these elephants.
The Koreans are in third and fourth place, and Nakayama's teammate, Taniguchi, is in second.
When he gets into this stadium, which is probably the best stadium I've ever seen in my life, 100,000 seats in the stadium. I don't know how many people are in there right now, but when he gets into the stadium, there'll be a great roar, and it'll help him on the last lap.
Well, Nakayama is maybe the new young blood that is moving up in the world of Japanese marathon running, and it looks like now young Nakayama, age 26, looking at his watch, going for here, maybe the one who's going to be taking over in the world of Japanese marathon running and the world. But Fred, he has to have that three quarters of a lap around the stadium, but this is the biggest moment in his life. He's running a near personal best record. Fantastic.
Now looking at his
watch and waiting.
The aristocracy. She falls to right. The aristocracy is.
Standing there with photographers around you. Won your title. Right.
We don't know of any art form. Has there been much attention given to sports? It's a very curious thing. Like when the
Lou Reed, ladies and gentlemen.
The current's reach so deep inside us. This is the age of video violence. No age or reason landing upon us. This is the age of Billy Wilder. And I said, na 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 na. Down at his job, his boss sits there screaming. And if he loses his job, life loses its meaning. His son is in high school, there's nothing he's learning. And he sits by the TV watching Corvettes exploding colors. McLaren's rage, or deep inside it. This is a video virus. No one is really looking upon it. This is the age of video virus.
I'm giving you my newest invention. So this is, this camera is inside, so you see? So, you see? The video ball, a tiny camera is inside there. This is newest tool to make exercise. This is much better than Jane Fonda. We will beat the Jane Fonda, and look, because it makes our exercise much more interesting. You cannot get bored. Sakamoto, it's very interesting. Oh, so you can take a pinch of. Thank you.